I see a winking invitation to find something entirely new.
We want to know where we came from, where everything started, why anything exists, why anything.
How the tiniest things comprise the biggest things in the universe.
Why is there matter in the universe at all? And does it have to do with neutrinos?
Neutrinos are the second most abundant particle in the universe. They're small, but they have big implications.
The way they behave is something that is the kind of thing that ties you into mental knots.
These particles, which are building blocks of nature, they can be so mischievous.
You start off with a particular flavor of neutrino, and as that neutrino then travels hundreds of miles, they change.
Neutrinos have been very elusive. It's taken us decades even to prove that they exist, let alone figure out what they're doing.
So if you want to make really precise measurements to take things beyond the level of understanding we have now,
you need a really ambitious long-term vision, an experiment that breaks all the boundaries, and that's what DUNE is going to be.
This program is looking for CP violation in the neutrino sector, looking for differences between neutrino oscillations and anti-neutrino oscillations, and hoping to give us a hint for why we live in a matter-dominated universe.
I was a kid when the Apollo program was starting, and I don't know whether I would put this at the same excitement I had when I was 8 years old. You're getting a chance to glimpse something that no one else has been able to see before. I think it's a real adventure.
This is where the story started of the neutrinos from the sun and where the first puzzles from neutrinos came about. We're here trying to build a new international collaboration in the US with partnership of other international labs like CERN and with partnership from countries around the world and scientists so that we figure out the mysteries around the physics of the neutrinos.
We picked South Dakota because the state of South Dakota had already built a beautiful underground science lab. And it was the right distance away from Fermilab so that when we shoot the neutrinos from Fermilab to South Dakota, there's a good chance that they'll do what we're interested in, which is changing from one kind of neutrino to the other.
Lead for 125 years was basically a company mining town. When Homestake decided to close down, the main economic engine within LEED was coming to an end. We completed the development of the lab in May of 2012. The experiments that we have underground now started to move in right after that and have been assembling and operating ever since.
The first experiment that showed evidence for neutrino oscillations was done at this site. This is really where the kind of science that we're trying to do began in some ways.
Those experiments were visionary, but you can only learn so much by looking at neutrinos from the sun. What's different about DUNE is by making beams neutrinos coming from Fermilab, we get to control what kind of neutrinos we're making. We know what they are when they leave Fermilab. And so you have a controlled experiment instead of just looking up into the sky.
We start off actually with a beam of protons and point it to South Dakota. And we accelerate those protons, make lots of other particles by smashing the protons into a target. And those other particles then decay into neutrinos.
The detector, the thing that enables us to sort of image the interactions of the neutrinos is also the target. We're going to build four modules that are 10 kilotons each.
We're sending physical things from one place to another, and the scale to do that stretches the 1,300 kilometers between those two places, the technologies we have to invent, the gigantic caverns we have to dig out.
And all of us, from the miners to the engineers, the physicists, we're all playing different roles in making it happen.
We're really talking about something that's so big, it has to be done truly at the planetary level.
We've assembled a worldwide community of people interested in doing this.
The model we're following is exactly the model of CERN.
The LHC was really the first full-scale demonstration that such international projects can function. Regardless of the political developments of the world, our goal is to understand science, is to understand neutrinos.
Physics for all humanity right now has become of pinnacle importance because it changes the way of our life. in a very fundamental way.
While you're doing the experiment, you may find something totally unexpected.
What begins with those basic questions about let's just understand the universe often turns into things that are useful.
The first effects come from people and technology.
The pursuit of curiosity has naturally led to that kind of advancement.
So if you care about the cutting edge, not just of science, but also technology, you need to support these kinds of efforts that pull in the best people from around the world to push the limits of everything.
If it's anything like the space program was, then all we were going to do is put a man on the moon. Well, look at the peripherals that spun off of that. Basically, the same thing I think will happen here.
Physics is part of our culture.
The drive to understand this is very similar in some ways to the drive that artists have to expand experience.
Answering a question begets a host of new questions.
How did we get here? What led to us being here? And we find as physicists we can't answer that question until we really know all the details.
We seek for those questions, and it is that which makes us human.
We're all searching and we're all trying to get to truth wherever it is.
Hope the voyage is a long one, full of adventures, full of discoveries. Laestrygonians and cyclopes, angry Poseidon, don't be afraid of them. You will never find things like that, so long you keep your thoughts raised high, so long a rare excitement stirs your body and spirit. Laestrygonians and cyclopes, wild Poseidon, you won't encounter them unless you bring them along inside your soul, unless your soul sets them up in front of you. Hope the voyage is a long one, full of adventures, full of discoveries.